Jamila Musayeva, an international social etiquette consultant and the author of two books, Etiquette, The Least You Need to Know and Afternoon Tea Etiquette. If you're familiar with my channel, you know that I always ask for feedback from my subscribers asking what are some topics you would like me to film more videos about. And a lot of you have mentioned Zoom call etiquette or any kind of etiquette related to online calls. So this video is dedicated exactly to that. Because most of us are now doing work online through either be it Zoom or any other kind of a medium, a similar kind of a medium, we have to abide by certain rules in order to make everyone in the community feel comfortable and respected. So let's look at some of the etiquette rules regarding a Zoom call. Rule number one is be on time. Just like in any kind of face-to-face meeting, I always urge my students to come early even for 5 minutes, but don't show up before it's actually the time for the meeting. Make sure that you do the same with your Zoom calls. Make sure that you prep your Zoom call, check for the microphone, check for the camera, check for the lighting, the location where you're going to be stationed, and make sure that you prepare everything that you need at hand right before the meeting starts. Because regardless the fact that this meeting is not face-to-face, this doesn't mean that coming early to the meeting is in any way acceptable. The rules work for online meeting just as much as they do for a face-to-face meeting. And again, if someone has allocated an hour for your meeting, coming up, turning in late for 10-15 minutes means that you take away that time from yourself, but also it means that you have no respect for the person's time that has, you know, allocated that for you in their schedule. So be mindful of that and make sure that you check everything beforehand and you show up on time. It is understandable that we can all face kind of internet issues or connection issues that are out of our control, and we have to be understanding and accommodating. But with that being said, if you're running late, make sure that you apologize for that and write why you're running late. If it's urgent, so it means that, you know, the meeting's about to start and you can't connect, then make sure that you phone the person if you have their number, or WhatsApp them if you have their number. If you don't have their number, then you can definitely reach them out by their email address. If you have 5 or 6 or more hours remaining to the meeting and you already know that you're gonna have issues with connection, then you can email the participants. Either way, just let them know that you'll be running late and make sure you tell the reason why. Rule number two, mute yourself when you're not talking. This applies to meetings when there are a lot of people, and by a lot I mean more than 5 people in the meeting. If otherwise requested to let your microphones leave unmuted, then you should mute it when you're not talking, because the background noise, if you drop something, if you take a sip of water, it can distract the rest of the participants, the ones that are actually talking. In my classes, I don't let students mute their microphones just because I don't want them to be distracted by anything else online. I know they can put on the music, I know they can watch another video, so I urge them to keep their microphones unmuted. But that's only specific for a classroom where I want to make sure that they're not distracted by anything else. In business context, in, you know, any kind of meeting for business, for work related, make sure that you mute your microphone when you are not talking. Rule number three is turn your camera on when you're meeting someone on Zoom, unless you have otherwise agreed not to do beforehand. So say you have written someone an email that you want to have a Zoom call, and you've mentioned that you'd only prefer to have an audio call. If both agree on that, then that's good. But if that's not stated beforehand, then assume that your Zoom call is going to be a video call. So make sure you prep beforehand, and when you show up, not turning your camera on is very disrespectful towards other participants. Because imagine a situation, someone has taken the time and effort to dress up, put on makeup, you know, establish a good lighting, took the time to prepare for the meeting, and then you go online and you tell the person, I don't want to put my camera on. So obviously the other person will not put their camera on as well, because if you're not putting it on, why should they? But also, they took so much time into preparation and lost that time. It's disrespectful towards the time of the other participant, but it's generally not a good idea to not put your camera on, because when a person can't see your body language, your eyes, it's very difficult to establish a rapport. It's anyways very difficult to establish a rapport online, let alone when the video is off. Rule number 4, make sure that you dress up. This applies not only to face-to-face meetings, but also for Zoom calls. It is important to show that you're ready for a meeting and you need to look decent for that. A lot of people have been sharing how they only put on a shirt and would be in their sweatpants. I don't think it's a good idea because sometimes, you know, something unexpected can happen, like your child might walk in or your dog might storm into the room and you need to get up quickly or do some kind of an abrupt movement, and that way, you know, you would be exposing your legs as well. So make sure that you wear something decent. I'm not saying that you have to put on the best work pants that you have, but try to make sure at least you have something decent on your bottom as well, as much as you have on your top. For me personally, I like to wear a dress because I know that, you know, if I stand up and have to show something, that I look proper and I look adequate for my class. So it's a personal tip that I have for all the ladies out there. You can just wear any kind of dress that you like and it's a lifesaver. Rule number 5, if you have to relocate or make a movement from one place to another, then make sure to turn your camera off before doing that, so the person who's watching you doesn't have to see how you're dragging yourself from place to place along with your camera. But again, this, you have to be mindful that if this is a meeting of only 5 people, turning off your camera to do so might look disrespectful. So what you would have to do is make sure you let the person or the host know that you're going to be doing that. Excuse yourself, say, I will turn off my camera for a minute, I need to relocate, and then do that. If it's a large meeting, let's say there are 50 people, there's no need to announce anything. You can just quickly put your camera off. You'll not be noticed as much as when you are in a little group of people. Rule number 6 is your lighting and your background matters a lot. In this way, it's a part of who you are. It's sort of a window through which the people are seeing you. So not only how you're dressed, but also the background and the lighting matters a lot. And I would say lighting matters even more. So make sure that you are facing a window or preferably a couple of windows. Make sure that there is no light behind you. There's no window behind you because it's gonna make you look darker and your face is not gonna be visible. Make sure that you choose a good background. And by good background, I mean something that's neutral, that is light, that's not distracting, that you don't have, you know, piles of clothes behind you, that it's clean and neat. I would suggest that you choose a particular spot where you're going to be having all your Zoom calls, so it's always ready and there's no need to really take care of it as much. But also staging is very important. When I'm having my Zoom calls, I make sure that I put a little stack of books in front of me and then put my laptop on top. I'm facing the window and I make sure I have a good background, and that way when the computer is a little bit above my eye level, it is much flattering to your face. Regarding the background, I also urge you not to use any ready filter backgrounds that's available on Zoom or Microsoft Teams, because I often find it to be very childish and unprofessional, you know, to have this background that's very blurry and gets mixed with your body lines and your face. It looks like you're in a tunnel. And I think if there are extreme cases, you know, when you are not able to find a good background, or, you know, you're somewhere out and it's not no place that will look professional for you, then of course you can opt for that. But if you're at home and you have a wall, then I would say go for a wall. Rule number 7, do not eat or chew on anything. Even if you're muted, you know, that movement of your lips is not going to be attractive, especially, you know, the sound, if you forgot to unmute your microphone, is not very pleasant for others to hear. So make sure that you eat and drink whatever you have to do beforehand. And the only thing that's acceptable during the Zoom call is a glass of water, a cup of tea that you can place by your side, especially if you have a couple of meetings back to back, or if you have a meeting for a couple of hours, then you definitely need to sip on a glass of water or tea to make sure that, you know, your vocal cords are hydrated and that you're able to speak for a long time. Rule number 8, eye contact is super important. Even if this is an online meeting, it doesn't mean that you don't have to look into the person's eye. And by that, I mean you have to look into the camera to make sure that the participant that you're talking to feels like you are looking into their eyes. I've had cases where students would just look to the other side of the computer or the other screen, or maybe another, you know, browser that they have open, and they will not be looking into my eye. It's very disrespectful towards the person that you're having a meeting with. So make sure that you look into their eye, and by that I mean look at your camera. Rule number 8 is take advantage of small pauses. Even if this is an online meeting, it doesn't mean that you have to rush to the points and make sure that you finish everything on time. Make sure that you take little pauses here and there, especially if it's a meeting with a couple of people. So when you take a pause, a person who wants to answer a question or maybe has a feedback or, you know, a reaction to your statement can just, you know, raise their hand or unmute themselves and, you know, contribute to the discussion. Even if it's just you lecturing people, you want to make sure that you get the feedback from the participants to make it as engaging as possible. Rule number 10 is make sure that you sign in from your own account, or at least you make sure that you change the name to your own name, because it might be a meeting where people don't know you personally, you don't know your name, and you're signed in from your brother's account or sister's account, and then when they're addressing you, they're using their name. Make sure to change the username to your actual name and last name if it's an official meeting, or just simply your first name to make sure that the person who is talking to you can address you using your name. I hate when people sign in with their nicknames because it's very disrespectful and I think it's very distracting and it makes the whole negotiation or the talk unprofessional. Rule number 11, do not jump in straight into the talk. Whatever the matter is, even if you only have an hour to talk about the issue at hand, make sure that you dedicate a couple of minutes to a small talk, because it's important. It helps you establish the rapport with a person that you're meeting for the first time online. Spend, you know, a couple of sentences here and there exchanging about the weather or your feeling, you know, something that you have in common or maybe how you met, and then you can continue on talking about the issue at hand. Rule number 12, and I think that's the most important rule that you have to take away with you from this video, is that be understanding and tolerant and accommodating of each other. In these difficult times when we have to work from home, we have to handle kids, you know, our pets, everyone at home, working from home, it can be very, very exhausting. And we have to understand that everyone can have issues with their computer, with their internet, with connection issues. And, you know, if someone does happen to come late to the meeting, you have to give them the benefit of doubt. You know, they might really actually have issues at home and not be able to connect on time. It doesn't mean by any way that they're being disrespectful towards you. But if they didn't apologize for that, if they didn't state why they were late, if they came in late, you know, chewed or ate something or didn't dress up for the meeting, then you can make your conclusions that probably this person wasn't very respectful. Otherwise, try to understand and try to, you know, put yourself in the position of the person that unexpected things can happen, and we have to understand and be kind to one another. Thank you all for watching this video until the very end. I hope that you find these tips useful and applicable in your Zoom meetings, and I wish every single one of you patience and kindness towards each other in these very difficult times when we have to only conduct our meetings through online mediums and platforms. Good luck to all of you, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!